In this video, I want to cover the single most important node that I think you need to understand in order to be able to create truly powerful agentic systems with AI. So here you'll see my personal assistant bot, and he's got all kinds of different tools on him, and each of those tools have other tools under them, and it's this big, monstrous bot that I've been building for the past roughly 7 months. And it all hinges on a single node. And it's this one right here. Let me zoom in even further. Zoom, zoom, zoom. The text classifier node. If it was not for the text classifier node, I would not be able to build as powerful of agentic systems as I am able to. Because this is the node that allows AI to be able to figure out what I'm talking about, to be able to make sure that it goes to where my request is supposed to be. So let's go ahead and take a look at it really quick here. So it's a very simple AI type of node. You can actually find it up here in the panel, so AI, and then come down to text classifier, all right? And what we do is we have an input where we put in the information that we want it to process. Then we then give it the categories of things that it needs to be able to choose between, all right? So in this case, I'm looking at weather, calendar, research report writer, my contacts bot, my news reporting bot, and then we have some additional options down here. So I currently have multiple options set to true as off. I have when no clear match turned on, and I have it output an extra other branch. And then we also have a system prompt. Now you have the ability to do enable auto fixing, and I do not have that turned on. And the reason I don't have that turned on is because I have this other branch. Like, I don't want it to accidentally decide to go up a branch it really shouldn't have if it chooses incorrectly. Instead, I want it to go down that other branch. And the other branch will then go to another text classifier that has a different set of categories. And that one has another other branch that goes to other categories, and so on and so forth. And across all of my orchestrator agent, across all of my manager agents, this is the tool that I am using to be able to get my AI to figure out what am I asking for to make sure that it goes to the right place. All right, now how do you properly get your text classifier node to work? Because I'll admit, let me come over here. I'm gonna copy this. We're gonna come down here, paste. Uh-oh, where'd you go? Okay, there we go. I have seen other people making these using text classifiers, and they'll have like a category for weather, and they might say something like, I'll copy that. Any requests about the weather? And they're like, okay, that should be good enough. And you know, calendar, anything related to the calendar. No, that's bad prompting. It's bad prompting. And it's bad prompting because this description is really the way the bot has to know in order to understand what is this trigger condition. So I treat this like a mini system prompt. I actually do treat it almost as a full-fledged system prompt where I give it all of its trigger conditions that it might need to be able to operate under, because I might say different things. When I'm telling my bot to do something, I might not say it specifically the exact same way every single time. So I need to consider what are those ways that I might respond or might tell my bot to do something. So, you know, I ask about the current weather conditions, or I might ask about future conditions. I might ask for weather in a specific location, or I might ask about weather conditions or metrics specifically, like, oh, what's the wind like today? Well, the bot may, oh, I'm all blurry. The bot may not understand necessarily that that's a weather condition that I'm asking about, unless it understands that because I've told it in advance. All right, so what you need to understand is when you're prompting the text classifier, if you're too vague and too general, you're gonna get vague and general responses. All right, so I even tell it the purpose, why it would route something here. I give it examples of what I might say that would cause this to trigger. All right, and I do that for all of my different examples. And then down here in my system prompt, I give it a list, a very specific list of what information it's getting, how it needs to understand that information, and then I tell it what are the different categories it might need, and I give it some extra tools or some extra examples. So in essence, I'm telling it one more time, this is how you need to process this information, all right? So that it sees it in its system prompt, it sees it in the description of the path, it understands that those two should match up, and when it sees something similar in the input, it now has three points of reference to be able to understand, okay, it's supposed to go down this path and this path only. Now, there might be times that it's not this path only, all right? I have other bots that If I mention one or two things, I want it to go down both paths. So as an example, I have my invisible council bot. That one, if I ask for, you know, George Washington and Abraham Lincoln to respond to a question that I have, I want it to go down both paths. I have a text classifier node there because it's supposed to choose which person am I talking to. But I have that one set to allow multiple classes to be true because I want both of them to respond. It then comes back together at the end and I get both answers. All right. So this node truly is the most powerful, in my opinion, when it comes to building agentic systems. And I think people are sleeping on this. I think too many people, let's go ahead. I think too many people are building this type of AI agent. Let me show you really quick. I don't care that it's not hooked up to anything. All right. All right, they're building this AI agent here where it has, you know, this tool. I don't care what tool it is. And it's got this other tool. All right. Yeah. The bot's going kind of slow because this is a really big bot and I probably shouldn't be playing around inside of it. We got that tool. And, you know, they just keep adding tools and tools and tools and tools. And, yeah, these may be manager agents. And this agent is choosing which path to send this down. But I like making sure that my bots get nice little bite-sized bits of information that it's able to handle without any complications. When you add complexity to these agents, when you add, you know, bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger system prompts, because each of these tools, the bot needs to understand how to call and when to call it and what it needs to do with it, what information it needs to pass to it. And you keep adding all of these tools on, that prompt just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And before you know it, the AI agent that you're using, the model you're using, it's not going to be able to understand what it's supposed to do, or it might miss something, or it might forget something, or it doesn't send the right thing. And you're going to be wondering, like, why doesn't my AI agent work? I just don't understand. That's because you're trying to load up one agent with just too much information. Instead, what I do is I'll show you. I have all of these different text classifiers, and each text classifier only has about four or five different tools that it's going to call. All right, four or five different tools. And that's it. Okay, cool. I'm like, oh no, my bot's broken. I see something's unhooked, but it's okay. What we want to do is we want to understand how does the computer process. And I'll admit that this system here, using these text classifiers and just chaining them together, might be a little bit slower than just having one AI agent with all kinds of different tools that it's able to call. It might get to the tool slower, but I'm almost assured that I've got the right tool, it's got the right information, it's gonna process everything correctly when I ask it to. So that's the text classifier node. It's, in my personal opinion, the number one most powerful AI agent tool that you have in n8n to be able to build agentic systems. So if you have found this video helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there to those who need it. Also, if you want additional helpful n8n tutorials or a ton of free workflows, click the link in the description below to go to my free school community. I've got everything from social media posting bots, lead scrapers, executive assistants, all kinds of helpful tools like the weather tool, my contacts tool, everything you see on this screen that you probably didn't get a good glimpse of, that's all available in my community. I give away everything that I make for myself to my community, and you can have it too. Just click that link in the description below, sign up, there you go. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.